Whenever you hear the word alien, you probably think of Hollywood movies or USA, because this is kind of a thing you have easily seen in American TV series. Now I don't know how many of you seen a show called Ancient Aliens. In that show, very surprising things are told about extraterrestrial beings, that is aliens. The show also tells how aliens landed on our Earth and how they contacted humans on Earth. Today I am going to tell you a similar story that happened in Himalayan region of India. Yes, you heard right. Aliens also landed in India. In today's video, you will know why and whom they came to meet in India. Now this incident happened with a person named Shri M. Shri M is an Indian yogi and spiritual guide. He has written this incident in his autobiography. When I first read about the incident, I was shocked because it was first time I heard such a thing. Now without wasting much time, let's get started with this. Narrating this incident, Shri M writes, when he went to Uttarakhand, he was staying with his guru in a cave called Arundhati Cave. Then Shri M says, it was night time, I was asleep, I woken up suddenly. I thought I woken up by lightning strike. I opened my eye and saw my guru Babaji, whose name is Maheshwarnath, sitting in usual sitting posture with his back to me near the dhuni he had lit. I looked beyond and I saw that something round about the size of full moon came out of two separate clouds, but it was not the moon. The object in the air looked like a glowing ball of fire, and the object was coming towards us with a terrible rumbling, then came in front of our cave and landed on the side of Dhuni. And what happened next, I had never seen in my life. I will never forget that experience. I was very scared after that object landed, but Babaji sat upright like a statue, unaffected, unmoved. After landing, the sound coming from the object stopped, and suddenly there was utter silence. That object was 2 feet in diameter, and then that object is split vertically into two parts. And seeing what came out of it, I got goosebumps. A large snake came out of that object with a hood like a cobra, glowing electric blue as if made of transparent, violet, glass-like a material with electric filaments lit inside. The snake-like creature's eyes were glowing and it hissed softly. I was very scared to see this, but then something happened that calmed me down a bit. I saw that creature fall at the feet of my guru Babaji, and Babaji raised his right hand and blessed him. The blue cobra stood up straight and sat in front of Babaji. Hissing conversation went on for quite some time. I did not understand anything in their conversation. After they finished talking, Babaji called me and said, those whom you see in front of you are the deputy chief of Sarpalok. His name is Nagaraj. Obeisance to him. I bow down to Nagaraj as per my guru's order. The Nagaraj hiss and touch my head with his forked tongue. And then being near him, I did not feel the least bit afraid. All my fears were gone. Then suddenly Nagaraj started moving towards his flying object. He entered in the flying object, and that object which was split into two parts was joined and closed, and making noise the object took off and soon vanished into the cloud. I thought it was all a dream. I could not believe this was actually happened to me, and there were many questions. So I said to my guru, Babaji, please explain this to me. Because even if I told someone what happened just now, then no one will believe me. Everyone will think I am utterly crazy or I am telling some fictional story. So please give me an explanation how and what happened. Babaji said, yes, you are right. When you write your autobiography and if you describe this incident to people, no one will believe you. But believe it or not, truth never changes. Then Babaji gave information about where Sarpaloka is in the universe. Babaji said, a stellar system exists in our Milky Way galaxy. It has 7 planets and 18 moons. One of this planet, his name is Sarpalok, and these planets are very developed, and hooded snakes live all over this planet. The serpent are called Nagadevtas. The supreme head of the Nagas is the five-headed golden serpent known in ancient Indian texts as Anantha. Thousands of years ago, when humanity was in infant stages of mental evolution, then there was a regular contact with Sarpaloka. Wise and evolved Nagas taught human beings on earth and educated them. Hence, in every pre-existing civilization on earth, serpent deities have a very high position. In almost every civilization, snakes are worshipped. It was the Nagas who taught humans about Kundalini energy, again symbolized by serpent. Maharaj Patanjali, who gave Ashtanga Yoga Sutra to the world, he himself was also a Naga and depicted as half man and half snake. This is how Nagadevta has guided us since before. But later, humans became powerful. They slowly got powers. Along the way, they became very self-centered and greedy. Once upon a time, many humans started harassing Nagas for their own personal gain. And humans, or the majority of them, were ready to even kill them for personal greed. Seeing this, the chief of Naga decided to call all the Nagas back to their planet and break the connection with Earth, except with some human beings who were highly spiritually evolved. Overnight, they were transported back to the Sarpaloka. But some of the snake who are old and rebellious, those serpents who disobey their chief's order, they decided to stay here on Earth. The serpents and snake you see today, they are the descendant of those people who lived here. But today, only highly spiritually evolved yogis are allowed to contact the Sarpaloka. Sarpaloka has kept its door open only for highly evolved human beings. Nagraj, who is the deputy chief of Sarpaloka, he came today. The reason for that is the issue running on their planet. He came here to discuss those issues with Babaji. They wanted the solution to those problems from Babaji. Now even Babaji did not tell me what those issues were, because it was very confidential. After hearing this, Shri M said to his guru, "Babaji, it all seems strange that I have written a biography which I will do in the future, as you say. Then the readers will either dismiss it as the raving of an unbalanced mind or as a pure fiction." Then Babaji said, "Truth is stranger than fiction, and even if they stimulate their imagination, there is hope that they might at some point realize that there is greater realms of consciousness that cannot be comprehended by dry logic and the currently available level of intelligence." After this happens, Shri M again goes to sleep and this incident ends. Be sure to let us know how you felt about this incident, and if you have some extra knowledge about extraterrestrial life or space science, so be sure to share in the comments and subscribe to our channel to watch more classic contents. Thank you.